Warm weather forecast with Chief Meteorologist Candace King.
Well, we've got a couple of light showers coming down this evening. A live look with our Mercer SkyTrack camera out over the Park Hills Golf Course in Freeport. You can see a little bit of that here coming down on the camera lens as we have a lighter shower working in from the west and southwest. And that is pretty much what we are going to see for the majority of this evening. So even though we still do have that flash flood watch in effect, I think our heavy rain threat or at least any thunderstorm activity really on the lower end of things here for tonight. But a couple of sprinkles northwest of Rockford from Freeport on down south. Once you get out towards Shannon there, right along US 52 in Carroll County, and a couple of sprinkles kind of working down parts of northern and central Ogle County. Not expecting much with this as some of the rain and thunderstorm activity has been confined to the south as well as up to the north. That's where some of the stronger thunderstorms have been. We've had the cloud cover overhead, and that's kind of limited the instability and cooled us off, relatively speaking, as temperatures are in the 70s to the west. We've got the 80s a little bit further to the east as we've been able to see a bit more sunshine. But it's muggy out there, and that mugginess is something that'll stick with us not only through the night tonight, but also during the day tomorrow. No rain for Ken and Belvedere 79. Said looked like it was going to rain all day, but like it's been the last several days, it's gone around 6/10 of an inch of rain though for Ben up in South Beloit 79, 1/10 of an inch of rain for Bob, our weather watcher here in Rockford, with the current temperature sitting at 80. Now I mentioned the mugginess, dew point numbers in the upper 60s and low 70s, so still that tropical air mass. So if we were to get some showers, yeah, there could be some more moderate rain, but nothing that'll be widespread here through this evening. And with the activity to the north and to the south, that's kind of gobbling up some of that energy that we would need to really kind of sustain some of those showers here through this evening. But nonetheless, as kind of a cold front works in from the northwest later tonight and tomorrow, I'm going to hang on to an isolated shower chance, but just know it's going to stay mostly cloudy, and wouldn't be surprised if we actually see some fog develop underneath some of that cloud cover early tomorrow morning. Now, cold front does come through during the day tomorrow, so the greater chance for any showers or thunderstorms will be to the south, but still might see an isolated one kind of pop up for the afternoon locally. Notice the coverage though, very, very isolated. Fog possible again Wednesday night into Thursday. Thursday, we actually get an upper level system that comes through, so we might see a bit more activity during the afternoon with the heating of the day. Something to kind of keep an eye on Thursday, but we do dry out once we head into Friday. City Market, this go around looking fairly comfortable. Now, I mentioned that mugginess sticking around even though we have that cold front coming in. That's because tomorrow our winds are still coming in from the west, so we don't see that drier air come in until Thursday. Thursday, our wind begins to shift around to the northeast, so that'll lose some of that mugginess or that humidity, and it'll feel a little bit more comfortable as we head into the weekend. 69 degrees, that's where we head for the overnight, kind of similar to what we woke up to this morning, 85 for tomorrow afternoon. So going up just a little bit as we should be able to see a bit more sunshine for the afternoon. We see the numbers dip on Friday, overnight lows in the 50s, so pretty nice and comfortable there. But look at that, guys, we head into this holiday weekend, could be in the upper 80s, close to 90 degrees on Sunday right now. Now looking dry and staying warm too as we head into next week.
Sweeping away that humidity will sure feel nice. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Candace.
Scott's in next to talk sports.